Hi, this is Teddy from Switzerland with another knife video, and today we're taking a look at another knife in our show and tell knife series powered by Tell Knives from Switzerland with their website www.tellknives.ch, a great Swiss online retailer that is actually sponsoring this video series by providing some knives that I'm interested in for a quick overview video. Of course, these knives have to go back to Tell Knives in resellable condition, so these are more overview videos instead of full-on reviews, but you certainly will get some useful information on these videos as well. So thanks again for Tell Knives for providing this opportunity. They are really a great store with a great selection of knives as well as very affordable prices for the Swiss and European market. So if you live around here, please check them out if you're considering to buy some new knives. Everything will be linked in the description below together with their Instagram as well as my Instagram, which is 7ready_knife_reviews. So this is episode 10 of our show and tell video series, and today we're taking a look at a very interesting knife that came a little bit out of left field for me because it's actually a gun themed knife. So we see here the pouch that this knife comes in, which is sporting the Sig Sauer logo, the German manufacturer of rifles and handguns. And you also see the Hoag Knife sticker, which actually Hoag Knives builds this knife for Sig Sauer, which is a very nice collaboration, and this is probably one of the best gun themed knives out there in my experience. I never dabbled too much in these gun themed knives. Hoag has made some other ones in the past, but those weren't really attractive to me. But this knife is actually drumming up some steam in the knife community at the moment. There have been a bunch of pretty positive reviews on this K320 6-hour knife, and I actually can understand why. This is surprisingly good, especially for a gun themed knife, which is normally pretty sneezed at in the knife community, but Hoag has actually been able to produce something very worthwhile while still incorporating the 6-hour thing into the knife, and it actually works to the benefit of the knife this time, which is not that often seen in these kinds of knives in my opinion. But let's dive into the specs of the 6-hour K320, look at all the different options that we have with this knife. So first off, this is the standard kind of manual model, so we have a black coated, I think this is a Cerakote, on the blade finish with a drop point blade. All the blade shapes are available in a plain edge as we have it here, as well as in a partially serrated option. Then there is a gray handled version. These are a polymer handle, the same polymer used in the K320 pistol, and it also has the same kind of polymer stippling that you would see on a pistol like that, and that actually is really really comfortable and feels actually quite good in hand. And then you have also a tanto bladed version available on the 6-hour and Hoag K320, and there is also a like desert sand finish version, and these knives are also available in an automatic version as well. All of them sport F30V40 steel, as you can see right here. All of them are made in the United States by Hoag for 6-hour, and the manual version sport this Able lock, which is very reminiscent of a Benchmade Axis lock, just in the special Hoag kind of flavor. And all of them support a repositionable deep carry clip, which also sports the American flag, signifying that this is made in the US. So other specs on the Hoag 6-hour K320 are the overall length at 8 inches or 20.3 centimeters with a blade length of 3.5 inches or 8.9 centimeters. Of course, you're getting quite a bit less cutting edge because you have a nice forward finger choil that feels super comfortable. Then you have a handle length of 4.5 inches or 11.4 centimeters. As I said before, the steel is CPM S30V, and the Rockwell hardness claimed on this blade by Hoag is 59 to 61. Weight-wise, we're looking here at 116 grams or 4.18 ounces. So certainly not overly heavy, especially for the size, but also not extremely lightweight. which you might would have thought because of the polymer handles, but it certainly feels lighter than I would expect a knife like this. It's also a little bit tip heavy, but of course you're getting a pretty broad and massive blade here in the front. So just a good overall weight here on the K320. In terms of pricing, Tel Knives hasn't listed this at the moment, but he certainly will later on. He has a great selection of especially Hoag knives on his website, so check him out if you're interested in some of the newer Hoag knives, because I think Hoag is doing a great job at the moment with the knives that they are putting out. Really impressed with what Hoag is doing. And in the US, you can get the K320 for around $128, and that's for a US made knife. So certainly price wise, very well priced in my opinion. Also, because I think these polymer handles are probably one of the nicest that I have ever felt. You know, I'm not a big fan of polymer handles in general. I didn't like the scales, for example, on the Benchmade Bugout. I changed those out. I liked some polymer handles on CRKTs because they really do it very interestingly, but I think in terms of overall feel and look, I think these look very great, and that also especially coupled with the gun theme, so you really have the same kind of handle on this knife as you have on the K320 if you own one. I actually took some pictures with this knife with my Smith & Wesson M&P9, which also has a little bit similar kind of polymer handles, and it looked really cool. So I can see why they went with this kind of theme, and I think Hoag did a great execution here on this folder. Now let's do some size comparisons that we do here on the channel so you can get a good feel for the overall size. It's certainly a pretty much full-sized folder here from Hoag and Sig Sauer. You can see here our Shirogorov sandwich. We have the F95NL at the top and the Neon Zero at the bottom, and you can see in terms of length, it's a slightly longer than the Neon Zero, so a good EDC kind of size. Then we have our benchmark EDC blades, which is the Para 3 at the top and the full-sized Benchmade Bugout. And you can see it's larger than both of them. It's pretty close to the Spyderco Shaman. I reckon I never had a Shaman, but looking at some other videos on this knife where I actually got interested in it, it is very close to the Spyderco Shaman, but certainly larger than a Bugout. And you can see much, much thicker. If you bring in the Para 3 once again, we can take a look at a thickness comparison there. And we can see that it is a bit thicker than a Para 3, but that certainly also aids in the handle feel in the hand. It really is a super comfortable knife in hand. You saw that I struggled there a little bit with the Spidey Flick. First, it's a bit harder here below the tripod, but also I really felt that I kind of interfere with the Spidey Flicking while touching the able lock right there, because you see I hold it like this, and when the able lock comes back, it kind of interferes with my finger there. But I can do it if I kind of choke back a little bit and then give it a little bit of wrist. But it is harder than on some other knives for me here on the K320. I normally use it just like that, because I also think this is kind of a no-nonsense knife, a real user, and just geared towards the guys in the gun community that need a knife just to use. And this is certainly one of the highest quality knives in terms of these gun-themed folders. And I think for an actual user, this is really well executed and will fit that kind of the market really, really well. Taking a closer look at the knife, let's take a look at the blade right here. So we have that nicely finished or Cerakoted blade here, nice and black. We have a flat grind starting pretty high up, I would say about 3/4 of the height. We have a little bit of flat portion, a nice swedge at the top, making for a medium strength tip right there. Then we have the Sig Sauer and K320 logo on one side, which is actually quite nicely done. And on the opposite side, we have the Hoag logo, USA, and the steel. So everything you need, nothing more. Pretty well executed on the markings. One thing that I'm not a big fan of is the execution of the ricasso area right here. So I like that you have the very comfortable forward finger choil, but I think this kind of guard portion, or just how the edge is ending here, just isn't ideal. No sharpening choil. This will make it harder to sharpen this knife. But that's the same issue you have on Spyderco knives that just end in the forward finger choil. So nothing unique to this particular knife, but certainly something that could be improved. Just give us a nice sharpening choil here. You don't really need this additional safety feature, in my opinion. That is just something that I noticed. In terms of sharpness, this was super sharp out of the box from the very limited experience that I had with the knife, because these are just overview videos, but very, very nice overall blade profile, some flat, some belly, medium strength tip, good size, nothing in the way, no thumb stud or anything. The opening hole is a bit on the smaller side, but it's very easily accessed with the thumb like that. Also, no occlusion from the other side, so it is possible to spidey flick it. But as I said before, I struggle a little bit on this folder. Maybe it's just my technique, but you can see it works. I just need a little bit of wrist, not because the action is not smooth. You see it's a free-falling blade right there, but just because of the way that I actuate that hole. But it certainly works, and of course also throwing it open with the thumb works well. Centering is perfectly done, and the able lock works very, very substantially. No play in any direction there, and it is very easy to use it. So this is a real ambidextrous knife. You have the able lock, which is easy to access from both sides and to manipulate with both sides. You have the four-way repositionable pocket clip, and then you have the hole deployment, which is also absolutely the same from either side. So if you're a lefty and looking for an ambidextrous knife, this certainly will incorporate that capability, and is certainly a great knife for left-handed users. Also, you have a lanyard hole that's nicely integrated, doesn't really take away from anything. It just continues these little stipplings there, so no issue there. Also, in terms of pocket clip, they have done that really well. You see that little, if you really look closely, that little area here where they actually took off the sharpest areas of that stippling, and that is actually where your pocket clip lands. We have that on both sides here, it's the same. So they really took some extra measures to make this not shred your pockets as much. It still is rougher than this part of the polymer, but it certainly helps quite a bit. And the pocket clip actually works really well. Super deep carry, very easy to extract because you got these little ridges right there, so it's easy to just extract the knife from the pocket. So very, very purpose-built overall design. In terms of the handle, it's absolutely not really compressible. That's also because you got some steel liners right up in there. You can see that some skeletonized liners on both sides that go almost all the way down there. They go about to here where the clip starts, and it feels very, very substantial. Also in the back, it's really hard to compress it, so it doesn't feel as flimsy as, for example, a bug out scale. It feels very, very substantial. Also because I think this is a very, very durable polymer, as it is used in the K320 pistol, so it certainly will be very, very durable. It's also like resistance to like acids and a lot of things, so this is really a very durable polymer handle, and this could be a real beater knife for you. Of course, with the steel that they have chosen, the S30V, which can be a bit chippy, isn't probably the best overall steel choice on this folder. Something like Maximat or some other, like for example here we have the Crewware would be a great option for a knife like this, but that certainly would add to the overall price of this knife. Some other comparisons that I forgot before is, for example, here the Benchmade Mini Adamas, and here we have the Hinderknife 3-inch non-flipper XM18, and you can see very close to the Adamas overall, a bit larger and certainly quite a bit more handle real estate that you can actually use. So I think in terms of comfort factor, I like the K320 better. Also, it seems to be a little bit thinner because it has more of like a contoured thing going on, getting a bit thinner here in the back than in the front, and that certainly feels super comfortable. So this is one of my absolute favorite knives in terms of comfort in hand, in the foregrip as well as in the back grip. It's super, super comfy. And I'm actually quite impressed by this knife. It has a bunch of things that I normally do not like the polymer handle, like the overall blacked out look, and of course also the kind of gun themed nature of it. But this really is a good knife. This could be a great user EDC, people who do some harder work every day, need your knife every day to at work. This could be a great thing. It will hold up very well with the Cerakote on the blade, with this very nice and durable polymer. It is super ambidextrous, and at the price of 128, I think for a US made knife in collaboration with Six Hour and Hoke, this is pretty much a great offering. So overall, really impressed by the K320. I think one of the best knives from Hoke, and Hoke is doing some great stuff, so that is certainly meaning something. This was my video on the Hoke and Six Hour K320. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. Put any questions in the comment section below. And if you're deciding to buy the knife like this and live in Europe or Switzerland, please check out Tell Knife's website. Once again, everything will be linked down below. Follow me here on YouTube for more content like this. And also don't forget to follow me on Instagram at 7ready_knife_reviews. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.